been trying to get this guy back on here for about a year. Last time we had him on here, he is our college football expert in sports talk. And if you're not in sports talk, you got to ask yourself why. He does have a lot of great stuff when it comes to the NCAA college football, which is taking a huge turn in 2024. But why do I have to tell you about it? He's going to tell you about it. He's Jason Acre. And here's a little moniker for you, Jason. There, see that? Jason, how you like that, man? Ain't that freaking professional? Like Jason, how you doing, man? How you doing on this Sunday
doing
on
well,
President's
Cash.
Day?
Doing well.
How was your concert last night?
It's really good, man. Blackberry Smoke puts on a great show. They played for over 2 hours. It was a great show. Every chance we get to see them, we'll see them.
Is that the kind of thing you get in Alabama? Because when I do retire here in about 5 years, the options are open to move. And I told the wife, "Hey, Montgomery's not that bad." And I told her that because obviously the rain and the weather here in Washington has now wore thin on the Honduran.
That took about as long as we thought, right?
Oh, poor girl. Yeah, she's a poor girl.
I mean, the Gump's not bad. You know, it's got its moments. It's still a small town feel to it.
Am I going to go there and get shot?
If you live in the wrong place, you are.
Okay.
But that's like anything else.
What a question. Am I going to get shot? Yeah. Yes or no? All right.
Right. Are my kids getting shot when they go to school? You know, I mean.
Okay. So. Hey, I've been telling people that what we've had going on with the NCAA, obviously the construct of the NCAA, they have no power anymore. And with all the latest moves, the NIL, for those of you who don't know what the NIL is, that is name, image, and likeness. A player can now make money off his name, image, and likeness. Jason, what do you think about, just real quick, is the NCAA as an association, are they done? Or do they have anything what do you think?
I think they're a vacuum. I think they're feckless now. I don't think they have any control like they used to. A lot of this is their fault, right? So,
true.
For years we've seen you go back to the 80s with SMU and the death penalty, and that held people in check for the longest period of time. But now it's just it's a place where rules go to die. Rules.
Well, they can't come back, Jason, and say, "Hey, sorry, you can't do this. Sorry, you can't." These players. This is unless it's a recruiting violation. But man, even that's done.
What is that?
What the hell are you gonna do? Here's someone said the only difference now in the NCAA than what it was in the past is now it's legal. But it has not stopped him from paying off players. And now some of these 17, 18-year-old kids making $3 million. Too. Fuck you, kid.
Right.
Okay.
Well, it's also, you know, when I look at it, you're right. The funny part is you'll have coaches that actually say this, and I just laugh at it because they say, well, the NIL is what it is, but we have nothing to do with who they go to invest in. Mm-hmm. They being the collective, they being who they offer money to, right?
Sure.
Well, come on, man. You're trying to tell me that the kid that was the quarterback that was going to Florida that got supposedly offered $14 million, Napier didn't tell anybody that's who he wanted to get their quarterback to be? It's just a lie, you know? Yeah. So, and it is where we are.
Well,
so the folks are doing it well.
What a load of crap. Well. Hey, fuck them kids, man. Those are kids. Hey, you posted something on Facebook the other day, and it was about ESPN and their Etch-a-Sketch. Now, they've done this before, but I don't want to say the word construct because now I've said that three times in one interview. I can't do that.
You own that word now.
I know. Fucking shit. Anyway, but we've said this for a while. I mean, it used to be once upon a time, long, long time ago, when I'd go to work, I'd be in my office. And I would have ESPN on all day. And remember, it was cold pizza. And then it's obviously ESPN has been on life support with their daytime program because, you know, only thing if you want to get a highlight, you go to the phone here. And by the way, me and the wife. And yeah, I have to give her some kudos here. But to be honest here, though, I'm sorry, I had the cough button here, or in this case, belch. But to be honest, I mean, ESPN has been scrambling for things now for a long time. That's why I cannot watch anything that is on ESPN during the daytime. I can watch their live events, and that's it. Now, speaking of that, as we've been talking about college football, the SEC is moving away from CBS, which has been a staple for a long time. And now they're going to, it's going to be a 10-year deal with ESPN. And it's no surprise that next year, the Texas and Oklahoma are now going to be over in the SEC a year sooner. Your thoughts about the quick move, Jay?
I saw it coming. It's not a surprise. When they made the decision to move, they were ready to go. They care nothing about whatever that Big 12 is, you know, the 12 little Indians.
Yeah, they haven't even had, but they haven't had 12 teams in.
right.
They haven't had 12 teams in about 10 years.
Whatever number you want to throw at it, right?
Yeah.
So, that moves about money, obviously, right? The SEC had the most rich or the richest contract at the time. The Big Ten has now taken over that, but it's all about money. You know, every SEC team is getting paid almost $40 million a year just to be a member. So Vandy just sits there and sucks and reaps all the reward. So OU and Texas can get used to that too. So, you know, if you win 7 games, who cares? You get to go to a bowl game that we're tied into and you get $40 million a year.
Yeah, I'm going to put it, I've been moving in here for the past 7 months, and I would watch OU. By the way, I gave the cats a bath today. I don't fucking tell you where I'm at today. But back to what I was saying. So I go in there and watch my, you know, I get up in the morning. It's 9 o'clock here when OU comes on, and the game's, I haven't had this happen in 23, 24 years. The game was done by the second quarter. All right. I think they're going to do better this year. They have to. They're going to have to, because you knew what was coming last year with fucking Oklahoma because of freaking Lincoln, Riley leaving and going to USC. And speaking of USC and UCLA, they're bolting too.
Right.
So the pack is dead, man. The pack is dead.
I don't know how they survive. There's only two teams left in the pack that have a national brand, really, anyway. That's Washington and Oregon.
I will say this. They're really getting behind this kid Penix. Michael Penix. Mm-hmm. And I've seen him a few times. He's a good quarterback. And him staying in for the extra years, financially it's good. It's what you can say now. Right. Don't tell me nobody offered that kid any money. All right. But now they're gonna get, I know. And they're giving us some Heisman hype, and he's going to go. He'll be a top 5 pick next year. Or he can be like Matt Barkley and have his stock just drop with a shitty one. All right,
Jay. I don't think that happens.
No, I don't think. He's a good quarterback. Last question for you. If this is a few moments with my friend Jason Acre, who thankfully is coming here on a Sunday, especially after going out to a concert the Saturday night before. And I remember. Last question. This is the sports depression here, the abyss that we're in. Quickly, your thoughts on what's coming up with Major League Baseball. Just a quick blip on anything that you see. Anything. It doesn't have to be earth shattering. It's something that you see happening coming up with Major League Baseball.
Can the Mets spend more money? That's the first thing I see. they keep spending money, and I don't blame them. That they expect to with that team. They expect to compete. I don't really know why that their offense isn't very good. I see them, Houston lost Verlander, and so that's a, but I think they're going to be okay. I want to see Ohtani and the new bullshit baseball rules that are for him and nobody else.
No,
it's his rule, right? You can't pitch anymore.
I don't know if they put – I think they put a provision in there. And I'll have to look it up, but I think there's a provision in there for Ohtani that if he is identified as a starting pitcher and he goes out – I mean, he doesn't play in the field anyway. He DHs. That's all he does.
Right. But still, right. But I mean, I think the baseball rules are silly. I think the shift rules to me,
the shift better. Rules.
I know.
That just tells me Major League Baseball players are fucking lazy.
Yeah, I agree. That's what I'm saying. Be better.
Will Clark had a thing, and it drives him crazy because, you know, Will Clark, one thing he can do is he can hit the ball, and he would tell his hitters when he was doing his spring training alerts going through, or it's a little spring training things going through San Francisco's system. You know, he'd go down there and say, hey, look, if you just turn 3 inches this way, you can shoot it down the left field line. And they wouldn't do it. He tried that with Brandon Belt for years, and Brandon Belt refused to do it. Refused. Right. You know, I was always good.
But I will say this about, and I'm an anti-Philly guy. If Philadelphia leaves the United States, I'm okay with it. But but watching them in the World Series and the playoffs, it was phenomenal. I mean, it was. I mean, everything about them. I like to watch baseball teams that look like softball teams.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what that team looked like. They hit big home runs. They know, all those things. So they're
so you're saying they should have one weekend this year in Major League Baseball where it says softball uniform weekend.
That's it. Right. That's it. And I want to see what Harper wears. Right. Harper comes out with a do rag, sleeveless shirt. You know, I mean, the whole works.
From someone who's played his fair share of softball, I tell people, hey man, you know, it's because they get some of these baseball players come out. I tell them, hey man, different game. No, it's not. Different game. Yeah, I mean, you got to wind up and hit it as far as you can.
Most of them really excel at it, though. But yeah.
Oh, as soon as they figure out, hey, I can swing for the fences and go from there.
Right.
You know, it's folks, it's always good when he gives me a few minutes, and he gave me about 10. Jason Acre, brother man, thanks.
Always, Cash. Later.